When you're working on media projects like video or animation, sometimes you need to convert a WAV file to an MP3. The most common reason is because WAV files, while they are very high quality, they are really big files, so they can bog down your actual project size, or if it's going out to an end user to watch, that size can really slow them down. So for instance, in my animation, I want to add this ninjarun.wav file to my project. Unfortunately, it's almost 26 megabytes in size. That's really big. And the quality difference, while it is better quality, is not so much of a difference that it really outweighs the cost of having a smaller file size. So if we compare the MP3 file that's been converted, you'll see that it is only 2.4 megabytes. So while it is a loss in quality, it's not really a noticeable loss of quality. Therefore, that file size is going to be better for my project. So I'll go ahead and delete this MP3 file so you can see how to convert a WAV to an MP3. In order to convert an audio file or any kind of media file, you need a media encoder, such as the Adobe Media Encoder. If you have any of the Adobe programs like Adobe Animate CC or Premiere Pro, then Adobe Media Encoder automatically comes with that software. So in order to convert this, I just need to drag this into the queue panel in the Adobe Media Encoder. Now, if there was anything previously in the encoder or in the queue, it's still sitting there. So as you can see, I've already converted this once. I'll go ahead and click the minus button to remove that from the queue. Now we just have our new file, ninjarun.wav. What you need to make sure is to change what you want to convert it to. So if you're working on video, you want to convert it to one of these video formats. For now, this is just an audio file, so we want to change it from a WAV to an MP3. Then you can choose which preset. So I'm going to choose the lowest preset. That's going to give me the smallest file size, and that's what I'm concerned with right now. But I can also do some higher quality versions of MP3. They are going to be a little bit bigger in file size, but nowhere near the 26 megabytes that the WAV file was. Then it's going to tell me where it's going to put the file. Generally, it's going to put it in the same place that it got the original WAV file. You can always click on the output file here to choose where you want it to go and what you want it to be called. So I just want this to be called ninjarun.mp3. So I'll click save. And now I look at the status area and it says it's ready. Now you can stop the encoding once it happens. And if you're doing a really big project, it will take a little bit of time, so you can stop it. This file, because it's less than 3 minutes of audio, is going to go actually really fast. So once I hit the play button to start the queue, you're going to see it encode down here, and it's going to kind of go in 1 or 2 seconds. So let me hit play and watch the encode down here. And once you hear that chime, the audio has been converted. So if we come into our project file, now you can see that ninjarun.mp3, and it's 24 megabytes. I would highly recommend, though, that you keep the WAV file in your project folder in case you ever want to go back to the high quality version, or in case you were just creating the MP3 to sample with, and then later on you put the WAV file in because you want a higher quality version for your final project.